In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you all. Dear brothers and sisters, I welcome you to the Cathedral this morning for the celebration of our annual Chrism Mass. This is the only Mass which is celebrated throughout the Diocese of Dromore on the morning of Holy Thursday. As you know, our parishes will meet later this evening to begin the great Easter Triduum with the celebration of the Mass of the Lord's Supper. But on Holy Thursday morning, the people of God are invited to gather, together with their priests and their bishop, in order to celebrate this Chrism Mass, which marks a great sense of unity within the diocese. But it's also the opportunity for us to bless the oils which will be used in baptism, in the sacrament of the sick, and also to consecrate the oil of chrism. This is also the Mass at which all of the priests of the diocese renew their commitment to the priesthood that they made on the day of their ordination. And therefore, any priests who are resident within the diocese are welcome to attend this Mass in order to renew their priestly promises. And I'm delighted to welcome my brother priests here this morning. To prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind ourselves. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Paterum omnipotens, Domine fili unigenite, Jesu Christe. Domine Deus agnus Dei, filius patris, et solis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Et solis peccata mundi, suscipe de peccationem nostra, qui sedes ad dexteram patris, miserere nobis. Quoniam tu solus sanctus, tu solus dominus, solus altissimus, Jesu Christe, cum sancto spiritu, in gloria Dei patris.
Let us pray. O God, who anointed your only begotten Son with the Holy Spirit and made him Christ and Lord, graciously grant that, being made sharers in his consecration, we may bear witness to your redemption in the world. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me, for the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the poor, to bind up hearts that are broken, to proclaim liberty to captives, freedom to those in prison, to proclaim a year of favor from the Lord, a day of vengeance for our God, to comfort all those who mourn, and to give them for ashes a garland, for mourning robe the oil of gladness, for despondency praise. But you will be named priests of the Lord. They will call you ministers of our God. I reward them faithfully and make an everlasting covenant with them. Their race will be famous throughout the nations, their descendants throughout the peoples. All who see them will admit that they are a race whom the Lord has blessed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will sing forever of your love, O Lord. I will sing forever of your love, O Lord. I have found David my servant, and with my holy oil anointed him. My hand shall always be with him, and my arm shall make him strong. I will sing forever of your love, O Lord. My truth truth, and my love shall be with him. By my name his might shall be exalted. He will say to me, you are my Father, my God, the rock who saves me. I will sing forever of the love, O Lord.
A reading from the book of the Apocalypse. Grace and peace to you from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn from the dead, the ruler of the kings of the earth. He loves us and has washed away our sins with his blood and made us a line of kings, priests to serve his God and Father. To him then be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. It is he who is coming on the clouds. Everyone will see him, even those who pierced him, and all the races of the earth will mourn over him. This is the truth. Amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is, who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of eternal glory. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of eternal glory. The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me. He has sent me to bring the good news to the poor. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of eternal glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day, as he usually did. He stood up to read, and they handed him the scroll of the prophet Isaiah. Unrolling the scroll, he found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me, for he has anointed me. He has sent me to bring the good news to the poor, to proclaim liberty to captives and to the blind new sight, to set the downtrodden free, to proclaim the Lord's year of favour." He then rolled up the scroll, gave it back to the assistant, and sat down. And all eyes in the synagogue were fixed on him. Then he began to speak to them. "This text is being fulfilled today, even as you listen."
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
It's a great joy to gather once more here in the Cathedral of St. Patrick and St. Colman for the Chrism Mass. The anointing with the oil of chrism has a special significance in the life of the Church. Whenever at the end of this Mass I consecrate the chrism in communion with the priests who are present here, the first thing I do is to breathe over the oil. That's to symbolize the coming down of the Holy Spirit. And it's also to emphasize the life-giving, sanctifying character of the sacraments where chrism is used. You see, chrism marks us out for a special service. Through anointing with chrism, we are consecrated. We're set apart to serve God. And that is why Holy Chrism belongs to the sacraments of baptism, confirmation, and ordination, because these are the sacraments which impart an indelible character on us. They seal us with a particular calling and service in mind, so that we may be God's witnesses in the midst of a busy world. But what does this setting apart mean nowadays, this consecration for special service? Well, in the early decades of the Church, people noticed that Christians were different. They were kind of a people apart. And that was because they were prayerful. They had a great sense of charity. They were joyful and happy people. Christians had a peaceful nature. And they were willing to suffer for their faith. But one of the things that people noticed about these Christians was the kind of unity and communion that they had within them. See how these Christians love one another, they said. And here we are 2,000 years later, and our challenge as modern day Christians is to be just as remarkable, to be a people set apart, to be recognized as people who are not afraid to witness to Christ, the Anointed One. Nowadays, of course, to be like Christ in an increasingly secularized world, it often means being countercultural. Our Christian convictions sometimes set us apart from many of the prevailing opinions within society. You take, for example, our very firmly held beliefs in the sacredness of human life from the first moment of conception until the moment of natural death. Or our Church's understanding of the importance of marriage and the family as the fundamental building blocks of society in the Church. Our Catholic Church's social teaching about the fair distribution of goods, for example, in the world. Care for creation. Our concern for the weakest among us, for the poor. In these issues, we often find ourselves swimming against the tide of secularism and moral relativism, where our challenging opinions are sometimes ignored or, indeed, on occasions can be shut down altogether by a so-called cancel culture. Something in particular which takes a lot of conviction and courage nowadays is to answer God's call to be a priest. And yet, when someone does embrace the life of a priest and cooperates with the help of God's grace, it's such a great, fulfilling vocation. In a few moments, we priests will be renewing our priestly promises before God and before you, our people. And we all know how special it is to give our lives to God in priestly service. And also how important and special it is for us to serve you pastorally, our people. It's a great privilege to be able to teach the gospel, to bring you the sacraments, especially the Eucharist. It's such a wonderful privilege to be able to celebrate Mass. And also, of course, to help you and work with you in making the world a better place. The life of a priest is so fulfilling. In a few weeks' time, on Vocation Sunday, we're going to begin a year which is dedicated to prayer and promotion of vocations in Ireland. And this year, the focus will especially be on diocesan vocations to the priesthood. Now, you know, at the moment, we don't have enough priests. We're getting a bit older. You might have noticed this morning as we came up the aisle. But interestingly, the theme of the year of vocations is take the risk for Christ. And during this year, I invite you, my brother priests, to tell the story of your vocation, your personal story, why you decided to become a priest, and share it. Share it with young people especially. It's good for them to hear why we chose to be priests. And also tell them about the great happiness and joy that there is in being a priest today, in courageously following Jesus. Now, I'm not saying it's a perfect life. It does have its ups and downs, but so does married life. And I'm sure that you would say, marriage is a wonderful vocation. It's great joy, but not always. But any vocation takes sacrifice and commitment. So priesthood's no exception. We're not special. We just happen to have followed this call from God, which we felt when we were younger, and we said our yes. So I encourage the priests here today not to be afraid to say thanks to God this year for the gift of the priesthood. And of course, say thanks to our people. People like yourselves, who are such a great encouragement to us by your prayers and your resources and your words of comfort and your words of keep on going, Father, we need you. They really make a difference. In today's Chrism Mass, the people of God who are gathered are invited to pray for their priests and bishops, that the Lord may pour out his gifts abundantly upon us and keep us faithful as ministers of Christ the High Priest. I'm delighted that some of our seminarians are here today. And I pray also for the seminarians for the Diocese of Dromore, Anthony and Philip, who are continuing their studies in Maynooth and in Spain. And I'm also delighted that Deacon Carlos, who's here today, will be getting ordained next month. Carlos will be praying for you, especially in the coming days. I'm also delighted to congratulate some of the priests of the Diocese of Dromore who are celebrating significant anniversaries this year, like their silver jubilees, golden jubilees, diamond jubilee. And it's important to us to mark our priesthood. So please, celebrate with us and pray for us. It's interesting that the readings today speak of us all being a line of kings, priests, to serve our God and Father. In fact, when you were baptized, every one of us here, when we were baptized, we were anointed with chrism as priest, prophet, and king. All of the baptized share in the priesthood of Christ. That's important to remember. That means we also share in the joy of proclaiming the gospel. As today's gospel says, to proclaim liberty to captives, new sight to the blind, to set the downtrodden free. All Christians are anointed with chrism. We're all sent to bring the good news of mercy into a world which is often merciless and unforgiving. The oil which is used in the sacraments comes from olives. And remember what happens to the olives to make the oil? They're crushed. They are pressed. And it's the same fruit which grew abundantly in the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus suffered. Oil which the ancient peoples used to soothe, to comfort, to strengthen. It's very interesting that the Greek word for olive oil and the Greek word for mercy share the same root, eleos. So when we sang earlier, the choir, Kyrie eleison, that evokes not just Lord, have mercy, but also Lord, soothe me, comfort me, Lord, anoint me. I invite you today, as the priests renew their priestly promises, and as we all together witness the blessing of the oils and the consecration of the chrism, to renew your own personal vocation as a baptized child of God with a mission to bring mercy, love, and the joy of the gospel into the world. So I now invite my brother priests who are present to stand for the renewal of our priestly promises. Beloved sons, on the anniversary of that day when Christ our Lord conferred his priesthood on the apostles and on us, are you resolved to renew in the presence of your bishop and God's holy people the promises you once made? Are you resolved to be more united with the Lord Jesus and more closely conformed to him, denying yourselves and confirming those promises about sacred duties towards Christ's church, which, prompted by love of him, you willingly and joyfully pledged on the day of your priestly ordination? Are you resolved to be faithful stewards of the mysteries of God in the Holy Eucharist and the other liturgical rites, and to discharge faithfully the sacred office of teaching, following Christ the head and shepherd, not seeking any gain, but moved only by zeal for souls? Brothers and sisters, I invite you to stand, please. And I ask you, dearest sons and daughters, pray for your priests, that the Lord may pour out his gifts abundantly upon them, and keep them faithful as ministers of Christ the High Priest, so that they may lead you to him who is the source of all salvation. Christ, hear us. Christ, graciously hear us. And pray also for me, that I may be faithful to the apostolic office entrusted to me in my loneliness, and that in your midst I may be made day by day a living and more perfect image of Christ, the priest, the good shepherd, the teacher and servant of all. Christ, hear us. Christ, graciously hear us. May the Lord keep all of us in charity and lead us all as shepherds and flock to eternal life. Amen. Can I ask you to pray for priests and deacons, members of our clergy, who have died since we last met at the Chrism Mass? I'm thinking of Deacon John McClelland and Deacon Brendan McAllister, the first of our permanent deacons to go to their rest. I pray also for the Right Reverend Dean Artie Byrne, who died last month. He was the oldest priest of the diocese. I'd like to pray also for Father Jim Shepherd, priest of the Diocese of Down and Connor, who worked for a while in the Diocese of Dromore and who died recently. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, mercifully wipe away what is old in us, and increase in us the grace of salvation and newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit,
You made your only begotten Son, High Priest of the new and eternal covenant. And by your wondrous design, we're pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your people the Paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Dominus, Deus
Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on to the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them, we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in the hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord, Jesus Christ, and Blessed Joseph, our spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogenus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damien, and all your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we may be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, the Almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord. We, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, a place of light, and a place of peace.
To
to us also your servants, although sinners, continue to hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merit, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them.
Blessing of the oil of the sick. Lord God, loving Father, you bring healing to the sick through your Son, Jesus Christ. Hear us as we pray to you in faith, and send the Holy Spirit, man's helper and friend, upon this oil, which nature has provided to serve the needs of men. May your blessing come upon all who are anointed with this oil, that they may be freed from pain and illness and made well again in body, mind, and soul. Father, may this oil be blessed for our use in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you forever and ever, through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere, Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostri. Et ne nos inducas in tentatione, sed libera nos a malo. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Distribution of Holy Communion, we remind you that those of you who are seated in the central aisle will be invited to begin coming up from the back. So we ask you to please follow the guidance given to you by the stewards. Those of you who are seated in the transepts of the cathedral will receive communion in the transepts. And those of you seated on the side aisles, we will invite you to please go down the side and come up the central aisle for Holy Communion when invited to do so. If anybody is unable to approach the altar for communion, please advise one of the stewards and communion will be brought to you in your seat. And we remind those of you who wish to receive communion on the tongue to please wait until the very end of the communion procession. Thank you.
Let us pray. We beseech you, Almighty God, that those you renew by your sacraments may merit to become the pleasing fragrance of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
The blessing of the oil of catechumens and the consecration of the chrism. Lord God, protector of all who believe in you, bless this oil and give wisdom and strength to all who are anointed with it in preparation for their baptism. Bring them to a deeper understanding of the gospel, to help them to accept the challenge of Christian living, and lead them to the joy of new birth in the family of your church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For the preparation and consecration of the sacred chrism, I've noticed some of the boys and girls here from the different schools nearby. If you'd like to come up, because this is the oil that is used in the sacrament of confirmation, and I know that some of you will be receiving the sacrament soon. So please come up and gather round so that you can see what's happening. So the first thing I'm going to do is to pour into the oil of chrism this, which is called balsam, and it is actually a perfume. So it goes into it. The actual oil is olive oil. You heard me mentioning that earlier, olive oil. So pour in the balsam. Mix it round a bit. Let us pray that God, our Almighty Father, will bless this oil so that all who are anointed with it may be inwardly transformed and come to share in eternal salvation. So I'm going to breathe over the oil now as a sign that we're calling down the Holy Spirit. God, our Maker, source of all growth and holiness, accept the joyful thanks and praise we offer in the name of your church. In the beginning, at your command, the earth produced fruit-bearing trees. From the fruit of the olive tree, you have provided us with oil for Holy Chrism. The prophet David sang of the life and joy that the oil would bring us in the sacraments of your love. After the avenging flood, the dove returning to Noah with an olive branch announced your gift of peace. This was a sign of a greater gift to come. Now the waters of baptism wash away the sins of men, and by the anointing with olive oil, you make us radiant with your joy. At your command, Aaron was washed with water, and your servant Moses, his brother, anointed him priest. This too foreshadowed greater things to come. After your son, Jesus Christ our Lord, asked John for baptism in the waters of the Jordan, you sent the Spirit upon him in the form of a dove, and by the witness of your own voice, you declared him to be your only well-beloved son. In this, you clearly fulfilled the prophecy of David that Christ would be anointed with the oil of gladness beyond his fellow men. And I invite all of the priests present to extend their right hands towards the chrism. And so, Father, we ask you to bless this oil which you have created. Fill it with the power of your Holy Spirit through Christ your Son. It is from him that chrism takes its name, and with chrism you have anointed for yourself priests and kings, prophets and martyrs. Make this chrism a sign of life and salvation for those who are to be born again in the waters of baptism. Wash away the evil they have inherited from sinful Adam. And when they are anointed with this holy oil, make them temples of your glory, radiant with the goodness of life that has its source in you. Through this sign of chrism, grant them royal, priestly, and prophetic honor, and clothe them with incorruption. Let this indeed be the chrism of salvation for those who will be born again of water and the Holy Spirit. May they come to share eternal life in the glory of your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And boys and girls, thank you so much for coming this morning. We'll be praying for you on your confirmation day. And if has anybody already received the sacrament of the Mayo Bridge once? So you're already full of the Holy Spirit, so please pray for us. Boys and girls, pray for us and we will pray for you. You can go back down to your places again. And before the final blessing, I just want to say a word of thanks to all of you for being here this morning for this very solemn and beautiful Mass of Chrism. And on behalf of all of the priests here, just want to say thanks to you for your continued prayers and encouragement which keep us going day by day in our ministry. And I also, as bishop here and apostolic administrator in the Diocese of Dromore, I want to say a word of thanks to my brother priests for all that you do during the year to look after and care for your people, to pray for them and to lead them. The Lord be with you all. Can we thank God for this wonderful liturgy and thank God for the opportunity that we have to celebrate the sacraments, knowing that throughout the world there are people, brother Christians, sister Christians, who do not have the opportunity that we have because of persecution or because of displacement due to war or other reasons. Thanks so much to everybody who took part in the liturgy. A special word of thanks to the wonderful choir from St. Coleman's, celebrating the great anniversary year this year. Great. Thank you so much to, I see Miss Frame up there. Thanks to Dara and everybody else who has helped to prepare for the singing today, which was very beautiful indeed. We beseech you, Almighty God, that those you renew by your sacraments may merit to become the pleasing fragrance of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God be upon you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.